What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. You guys, today I'm going to kind of show you the difference, right? I'm going to show you how simple it is and how effective it is to simply do something different, right? And there's simple tweaks to the content you're already putting out. Now, if you're putting out images, and this applies for any platform, you guys, any platform, right? Any platform. You're either putting out images or you're putting out video content, right? Here on YouTube, a lot of you guys are catching this on YouTube. And then also, you know what? I'm going to put this out on Facebook as well. So a lot of you are going to catch this on Facebook as well. Here's the difference. You got, in my professional opinion, after doing this for several years now, consulting, social media marketing, Facebook advertising, it's all the same. So pick your platform. It's all the same. You're either putting out images or you're putting out video. And you're either putting it out organically or you're simply running ads, right? And so I've just been a huge advocate. I've just had a ton of passion in the simplicity and the effectiveness of running a freaking ad. If you're already going to be putting out content, why not run an ad? It's a huge, huge difference. And I'm going to show you. In today's video, so if you get any value from this, man, at least give me a thumbs up. If you're not going to subscribe on YouTube or whatever, at least thumb it up. Thumb it up if you get any value. And I promise you, stay to the end, you're gonna get value because I'm gonna literally show you how to do this. Two types of people, right? Image, video, or organic paid ads, right? And so all I'm saying is that at the end of the day, after speaking to so many people, consulting, social media marketing, Facebook advertising, at this point, speaking to thousands of real estate agents, thousands of local business owners, right? All over the country. And even because of my YouTube channel, even around the world, shout out to my clients in South Africa. Shout out to my clients in Australia. Shout out to my clients in Canada, right? It's like, dude, it's insane organically, right? Organically. But then at the same time, these are local business owners. After speaking to so many local business owners, I truly believe it's all about ads. And I'm going to show you the difference. I'm going to show you the difference today. I'm going to literally, as I put out more video content on my Facebook page, right? If you're catching this on YouTube, if you've been following me on YouTube, look back at all my videos on YouTube. I literally have hundreds. I made a decision a few years ago that if I was going to put out anything on social media, I was going to try to teach something. So that means I have to get good at something, right? And I was going to focus in on one thing, right? I wasn't going to try to do everything. And so me personally, on this YouTube channel, that's where I decided to put all the content. I'm like, dude, if YouTube is going to expose more, if YouTube is going to reach more, if YouTube is going to pay me monthly on this video content on YouTube, I'm going to just put everything there. And so for the past several years, Facebook ads, really two skills that I have, really, to tell you the truth, online, and two skills that I teach on my YouTube, right? Facebook ads and sales funnels. I truly believe those are the only two things that one needs. Real estate agent, insurance agent, mortgage broker, plumber, local dentist, local coffee shop. If you're a local business owner, local dry cleaner, I truly believe learn how to run paid traffic. And still to this day, 2024 and beyond, it's still Facebook. It's still Facebook. It's YouTube as well. If you're putting out video content, for sure, it's YouTube ads. It's just what you want to be doing. I just truly believe YouTube, they're paying us. It's like, dude, if I'm gonna put out video content, I might as well get paid for it. That's been YouTube. And that's why YouTube has exploded. That's why people create YouTube channels, because let's keep it real. It is about the money, the money also, monetizing it. YouTube sends that monthly check to me. So I'm like, shit, if I'm gonna put out any content at all, I might as well teach something. I might as well put it in video form like that, because that's what's trending and that's what's blowing up and that's what's over here that we're consuming, right? Video content. And I'm like, dude, okay, I'm gonna do it on YouTube. Moving forward, 2024 and beyond, I'm going to start putting a few videos on Facebook, right? I've been super successful with my personal Facebook page. So I really haven't even had to build out my Facebook business page organically at all, or even running video ads, because I have different pages that I run ads on. But this one specifically, this Facebook business page specifically, you're going to start seeing me put out video content. And here is the difference. As 99% of you guys simply take that video, and let's go straight into it. Let me share my screen. As 99% of you guys put out video content. You could be like, hey, David, I'm putting out a video on that listing. I'm putting a video out on that open house. I'm putting out a video about me educating people about my insurance business, about my plumbing business, about my air conditioning business, right? If you're that person putting out that video content, you're saying, David, I'm already doing that. Yes, dude, you're doing it organically. And how's that even working? As thousands of people start to follow us on social media, these are thousands of people that don't even live in our area. Keep it real. If I was a local business owner here in San Diego, how many of you people watching this video right now could do business with me? Comment below. Comment below if after consuming this video and you're like, dude, David has a local business. David is a plumber. I would love to work with David. How many of you would, dude, let's say I got thousands of friends on Facebook, thousands of subscribers on YouTube, thousands of followers on Instagram. Let's say I have thousands of followers on TikTok. I have thousands of followers on LinkedIn. How many of you guys that are watching this would be like, dude, David, I'm down to hire you. You're a plumber. You have a coffee shop in San Diego. Holy shit, I'm out here in Tampa Bay. I just follow you on LinkedIn. It's like, dude, right? So the difference is, you guys, as I start to put out video content on my Facebook business page, I'm not going to be putting out like 99% of you bozos that are just putting it out organically, putting out a video on Twitter, putting out a video on Instagram. No, dude, if I'm going to put out a video on Instagram or on Facebook business page, I might as well run an ad on it. And I'm going to show you today, how I'm going to do that. And I'm going to show you today how I'm going to do that for literally $1 a day. So if you're saying, David, I post video and I put it on my Facebook personal page, David, I share it to Facebook groups. I'm going to show you right now. This is a Facebook group that I have, right? A little over 4,000 people. I'm the admin. This is my Facebook group. Roxanne, my bad, Roxanne, but I have to decline you. I have to decline you too, drone guy. This is a Facebook group, right? That I control. This is my group where I just have a bunch of real estate agents from all over the country come in here and post their listings. They'll come in here and post their open houses, right? Shout out to Bill with his open house. This is organic. So God bless Bill. But I'm going to keep it real. And I could scroll down, show you 1,000 of the same posts. It's all the same. It's all the same. As we come out here and post organically, you're putting it on your personal Facebook page. You're sharing it to your Facebook business page when you got 400 people who like it. And it's all your uncles and aunts. And you're calling that marketing. Or you're taking this and putting it on LinkedIn. Or you're taking this on and putting it on Instagram because you got 5,900 followers on Instagram and 99% of them live across the country. Again, if you and I were connected on Instagram, I'm in San Diego. My listing is in San Diego. How many of you guys are interested? You're one of my 5,900 followers on Instagram. You're one of my 5,900 followers on TikTok. You're one of my 5,900 followers on LinkedIn. I have an open house in San Diego. I have a just listed in Clarksville, Tennessee. How many of you are interested in this property right here because you live down the street? Damn near 100% of you guys don't live in Clarksville, nor are you ever moving to Clarksville. So as Michelle posts organically and she puts that image that just listed in Facebook groups, on her personal page, on her business page, on her Instagram account, on her LinkedIn, she even does a TikTok to it in front of it. As she's doing that organically, damn near 100% of us that see it, no matter what platform I'm seeing it on, don't live in that area. So when you post it in a group of even 4,000 people, you would think a Facebook group of over 4,000 like-minded people, you would think that that would do something, right? Look at this. It reached 5 people. I get to see the insights because this is my group. I'm one of the 5. I live in San Diego, California. I could give a damn about Clarksville, Tennessee, and vice versa. So no disrespect, it's just shit. It's like, dude, come on, this is not marketing. This is not marketing. That's option A. That's what I truly believe 99% of you guys watching this video are doing. 99.9, to tell you the truth, are just posting organically. And if that's working for you, shout out to Bill. If that's working for you, okay, shit, keep doing it. But I'm willing to bet it's not. Because the flip side of it, which is what I'm about to show you, is night and day. If I'm going to spend the energy and post, I don't need to post it everywhere. I could simply just post it on Facebook, on my business page, and run it as an ad. And I don't have to spend a lot. I'm going to show you right now, you guys. I put up a video on my Facebook business page. So now let's go to my business page. I put up a video here that again, as I go 2024, you're going to see me putting a lot more videos on this business page. 2025, you're going to see me. Now I am pivoting and going all in on real estate investing as well. So you may, on my YouTube channel, canteromedia.com. But if you're catching on YouTube, you'll see the link in the description. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, because moving forward, late 2024 into 2025, I'm gonna be teaching a lot about real estate investing, because I'm gonna be doing it. I'm gonna be investing, right? So I want to really document all that and turn that into something special as well. But over here on Facebook, you're gonna continue to see videos. But again, unlike posting it, like 99% of people organically, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this one right here and I'm gonna run it as a Facebook ad. That's all I'm gonna do, you guys. That's all I'm gonna do. This video right here, you're seeing it right now with 19 views. Okay. By the time you see this video, by the time this video goes live, look at that number. Look at that number. Look at that number. And if that number has grown since the time you've seen this, comment on the video. See, David, saw the video. Holy crap. It grew from 19 to 1900, and it's been 9 hours. You guys, that's what I'm saying. Rather than posting organically to people random all over the damn world, put a few bucks. I'm gonna literally take this. Dude, let's get into it. Let's get into it. Let's get into it. I'm gonna take this, and if you guys haven't set up your business manager, make sure you set up your business manager. Go to your home feed right here to the top left, or the middle. Click on the home, come to the left, click on Ads Manager. Okay, we want to click on Ads Manager. So one thing you want to do for sure, you guys, is once you get to the back end, this is your business manager. Make sure you have your business manager set up. Just don't run ads through your ad account, okay? Don't just run ads through just your ad account by that you have by default, right? You want to set up your Facebook business manager. So again, if you're catching this on YouTube, there's going to be a link in the description on how to set up your business manager, or just come to my channel, come to my YouTube channel and search Facebook business manager setup, David Cantero, and you'll find a million videos that I have on YouTube that take you through the setup. You want to set that up first, okay? Because what I'm going to take you in through now is, again, this video right here. We're like, okay, I don't want to be person A. I don't want to just post organically on all these damn platforms and have to do that day in and day out just to attract freaking people from all over the world. If I'm a local business owner, and again, this is for the local business owner. If you have a product or service and you're selling it online and you have a global market, or you have a service like me, for example, where I can service local business owners globally, people find me on my YouTube channel globally. That's organic, right? That's why YouTube, I'm like, dude, I'm not going to mess with any of these damn platforms, only YouTube, because YouTube has the reach. YouTube's going to pay me, obviously monetizing the channel, the video content, right? But people find me, like people find me. So it's like, if any organic effort is going to go out video wise, it's YouTube, right? But again, now you're going to be catching me put more videos here on this Facebook page, but I'm going to be running an ad on them. That's it. That's the difference. That's the difference. The difference is that I'm going to be running an ad. I'm going to be targeting my market, right? And I'm only going to, and I'm going to be getting hundreds and even thousands of views. And I'm not even going to be spending a lot. I'm going to show you how to run this freaking video on a dollar, on $1 per day. $1 a day, you guys. $1 a day. I'm going to be person B. Person B is simply taking, and these are videos, you guys. These are random videos, right? These are not ad videos. These are not hardcore captured leads, freaking convert into sales. No, dude, this is not that type of ad. This is simple brand awareness. So if I'm going to post organically on any of these other platforms, not just YouTube, let's exclude YouTube for right now. If I'm going to post organically on Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter X, TikTok, Facebook personal page, Facebook business page, Facebook group. Now, obviously, I can share on Facebook, right? But I have to post on all these other damn platforms. If I'm going to do that, just to put out a video on my open house, or just to put out a video on my listing, or just to put out a video on my local business, it's like, dude, I might as well freaking run a damn ad. And here's the thing about running an ad, is that as all these bozos post organically all over the damn place all the time, this strategy, person B, this is how I coach my clients. I'm like, dude, forget about being person A. We're going to be person B. And all you're going to do is post one video every 15 days. That's it. So I'm going to run this video right here for 15 days. And then it's already publicly posted on my business page, right? That's what you want to do first. So post it on the business page first. Talk about your business. Educate people on the business. This video right here, I'm literally taking someone through. Holy crap. How cool is that? This is the video I want you guys to watch. So at the end of this one, come back to this video. Maybe come on. You could find this on my YouTube channel for sure. That video is on my YouTube channel, but it's here on my Facebook page. I'm literally going to run an ad, long form video. Look how long this video is, 151. I'm going to run an ad on this video, and it's simply for brand awareness. It's to get thousands of people to view this video. Better than your 400 views that are organically that are all over the place, or maybe your 40 views. Go to your business page and look at your videos. Go to your business page and look at your videos, your Facebook business page. Look at the view count. Many are even are under even 100. You posted a video on your business page. It's 3 minutes long. You're talking about your freaking open house, doing a walkthrough. 3 minute video. Look at your view count. Maybe 300, 400, 500, if that, organically, because all you did is put on the business page and shared it to your Facebook page. That's all you did. And you happen to have 2,900, friends on your personal Facebook page, right? And because you're a cute chick, damn near 90% of them are men. Keep it real. Who happen to all live across the country. So it's like, that don't do me no good anyways. This is what you want to do instead, you guys. This is what you want to do instead. Post it on the business page first, and rather than just freaking depending on that, and rather than just doing that, and rather than just sharing it to the Facebook group, because five people ain't going to do it. Five people are not going to do it. Like, as all, look at this, man. This is going on everywhere. Open house, five, nine people reached, right? This listing posted for, shout out to Lene 4 hours ago, a new listing, it reached zero people. Like 20 hours ago, shout out to Victor and his low budget video there, right? Reached one person, and I'm that one person. I'll give it some love, but it's like, shit, I'm not moving there. Victor's doing this all across the country, all across the freaking internet, social media world platforms. He's posting this damn thing everywhere doing that. That's not marketing, dude. That is not marketing. So, Victor, rather than doing this, bro, I'm telling you right now, running an ad on an open house, if you're a real estate agent, running an ad on an open house, obviously that's time sensitive. Even running an ad on a listing, that's time sensitive. But if you're out there just educating people, that's what this whole video that I have that I'm going to put out. As I'm out here just educating people, right? This is simply a piece of video that you guys were going to do anyways. We were going to put out this video anyways. I'm just saying, run it as an ad. Let's get to it. It's post on the business page first. I'm going to come to my ads manager, right? I'm going to click on the newsfeed. I'm going to come to ads manager. It's going to push me back over here. Make sure you're running it in your business account. And watch this video. Watch that video on my page. Watch that video. That's the business account I want you to set up first. And then you can come over here. Because what I'm going to take you through is a simple brand awareness. Now, aside from my lead, hardcore lead ads, Because you're like, David, that's fine getting thousands of views, but it's like, shit, if you're not going to capture leads from it, or if you're not going to get sales from it, why even run it? It's like, dude, not every post needs to be on running ads. Now, it can be, for sure. I'm an advocate of 99% of your damn content should be used for a damn ad. But if you're going to just put out video, because I put out so much, that's why I'm going to start pouring it into Facebook. Because I have so many freaking videos locked and loaded for YouTube, it's not even funny. I'm literally 4 months already scheduled out. My YouTube channel, 2 videos a week are going to go up for the next 4 months without me. They're already scheduled, locked and loaded, optimized, SEO, Google optimized and everything, right? That's why stay in touch on YouTube. Stay in touch on YouTube. And if you're getting any value, man, show me some love. I forgot what I was freaking saying. Let's just get started. So here's the thing. We're going to go hardcore and we're going to literally this again. Not every video needs to be necessarily for an ad. Here are the little, what I'm putting on Facebook is just the overflow, right? I just got so much love, man. I got so much freaking content because I eat, breathe and sleep this stuff. I teach people all damn day. I'm on calls all damn day, teaching these 5 basic steps to social media marketing, to capturing leads and or making more sales. But I broke it down to 5 simple steps. So let's chat or just stay on touch on YouTube and watch all my damn videos. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to hit the green button and we're going to come into, now these are all the different objectives, right? 99.9% of you guys watching this, 99.9% of the time we're going leads, right? 99% of the time, 99.9, we're going leads, right? We're going leads. That's your 2 videos a month, right? That's your 2 videos a month. 1 video every 15 days, leads, right? And if that video doesn't convert or isn't as fruitful, as isn't as profitable, then you simply put out your second video on day 16 to day 30. 2 videos per month, you should be crushing minimum on Facebook and Instagram alone. That could be leads. What I'm doing today is I just have overflow. I just have another random video, long ass video that I'm really, and the reason why it's long is because I'm teaching you how to set up your damn business manager. So watch that video that I'm literally running an ad on this video on. Watch that video because that's going to take you through a detail of how to set up your Facebook business manager. And reach out if you have any questions. Let's chat. This is just simply overflow that I'm going to be putting on my Facebook business page where I just truly believe it will bring a lot of value. And I want to show it to the right people. And I want to show it to a lot more people, many more people. And I want to do it for the least amount possible, right? Person B. This is person B, you guys. This is person B. So don't think you need to put out video content all the time, every time, all over the damn place. No, dude, you don't. Start teaching one thing. So if you're a real estate agent, start teaching, hey, okay, I'm gonna put out video content and I'm gonna put out a video. What I would do with, if I were you, I'd put out a video probably every week. I would probably produce 1 video a week. That's it. 1 video a week for a month. 2 of them are gonna be used for leads. 2 of them are gonna be used for awareness. That's it. So I'm showing you today in this video my awareness video. I'm gonna show you my awareness ad, right? I'm gonna walk you through how I set it up. Very simple. Person B, way more effective. Start doing this with your video content, you guys. And again, teach one thing. Focus in on one thing. If I'm real estate, I would focus in on just listings. Let me go out there and educate homeowners. Let my video content educate homeowners on what it takes to sell. I don't want to talk all this stuff real estate. I don't need to talk all this stuff real estate. I have an avatar. That's who I love working with, and vice versa. If you're a buyer's agent, okay, shit, and you love working with buyers, that's the content you need to put out. So don't think, you know, don't get overwhelmed and don't get confused with all of it. And don't think you got to be like, holy crap, I got to be all over the place. No, dude, you really don't. If you just stick to my basic coaching here, my basic teaching here, 1 video a week, that's for a month. 2 of them are going to be used for leads. 2 of them are going to be used for awareness. And you could tell in this awareness one, this is a long ass video, an hour, damn near almost 2 hours. This video that I'm going to run this ad on, almost 2 hours. 151. But again, awareness, you guys, awareness. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to do it for literally a dollar a day, $1 a day. Let's roll. Awareness, awareness, awareness. Okay. You put the same video out. You put the same video out organically and shared everywhere. I put it out and I simply run it at $1 a day. And I only show it to people who are in my target audience. Who is your avatar? The buyer or the seller? Pick one. Who is your avatar? And this applies to all you local business owners. Who is your avatar? It's not everyone. No, it's not, dude. So don't think you need to put out content for everyone. No, you don't at all. And by running an ad on it, minimizes the amount of freaking effort and time and energy and content you really need to put out. Because again, if you're going to continue to be person A and say, okay, David, I'm going to post everywhere all the damn time. Shit, dude, that's a lot of energy. That's a lot of time. If I just run ads on my videos, I don't need to put out nearly as many at all. And I'll crush you because I'm going to be seen by thousands of more people because I'm paying for it. And they're going to be people that are my actual avatar. They're going to be people who actually can afford my shit. They're going to be people who are actually homeowners. They're going to be people that are actually first-time homebuyers because I'm only going to attract them. And I'm going to put together a buyer's guide that they're going to click on and download for free, and I'm going to capture them as lead, right? This is basic stuff that I truly believe flies over everyone's head, okay? So awareness. Let's name this. Let's name it exactly what the video is for realtors and local businesses. Okay. Here's how I set up. I'm taking you literally behind the scenes, you guys. This is how I set my stuff up. And so again, as I pour into Facebook and put more video out on Facebook, all I'm going to be doing, man, is just running it. Not really leads, because I don't need leads at this point from Facebook. I get love from YouTube, and I love that type of a lead. So shout out to everyone watching on YouTube. I love all my clients, but when people reach out to you, it's different. That's what I'm saying. As you start to put out content, you guys, people are going to reach out to you. And when they reach out to you, it's a different lead, right? It's a different lead than you just trying to freaking cold spam people. I see it on LinkedIn all damn day. All I'm getting is spam-ass direct messages from people. I'm like, dude, where's all the, right? It blows my mind. So I love people that come to me when that's why I love it. I love it all. But that's why you guys know what I'm talking about, man. There's a difference between having a prospect for that lead versus that freaking being an inbound lead. That's a different lead, right? I love all my inbound leads. But here, that's the video. Okay. So that's the video. That's what I'm going to name. And these are our three levels right here. We're at the campaign level, the ad set level, and the ad level. Okay, so in the campaign level, the top level, one of three, the top level, as we're in the campaign level, I'm going to simply name it. And then in parentheses, I'm going to go with awareness. Awareness. That was the objective I chose. If I would have chose engagement, I would have put engagement. If I would have put traffic. If I went with leads, I would have put leads in parentheses. This gives me the ability just to look at the dashboard and know exactly what ad that is. I don't have to think it was leads and freaking have to click and see how many leads came in on it because it wasn't even a damn lead ad. Like, I don't got to do any of that. I could just look at it and know exactly what's going on. Awareness. Okay, now in this case, for categories, I don't need any categories. I don't need categories because I'm not in any of those. If you're in any of these categories, so if you have a lending business, you're in a credit card business, any financial type of loan, you're an insurance agent, you're a car salesman, then you got to go with credit. You got to hit the categories and just go with this one. So I work with a lot of real estate agents where they got to go housing, right? They go housing and boom, that's it. But in my case, I'm running this on my business page, Cantero Media. And I don't, you know, none of those apply to me. So leave that blank, leave all that off and hit next. That's it, dude. That's it. That's step one of three. Now we're on the ad set level. I'm going to name it up here. Once I set everything below. Okay, so maximize reach of ads. That's the performance goal. That's what I'm optimizing for, to get as many people to view it as possible. Maximize number of impressions, maximize ad recall lift. We don't need to mess with any of this. I could go maximize through play, right? A through play is someone that watches it. We'll try to show your video ads to people who will watch the entire video when it's shorter than 15 seconds. For longer videos, we'll try to show it to people who are likely to watch at least 15 seconds. That's a through play, right? So you can optimize for that. That's where I get paid. I mean, that's where I pay Facebook, right? That's when I'm charged. That's the cost per result is when I get a through play. It could be several cents per through play, but you never know until you run it. But we're talking a dollar. We're talking a dollar a day. So break up my dollar in pennies. There's 100 pennies there. Break it up however the hell you want, Facebook. That's what we're doing. We're breaking up pennies, you guys. We're breaking up pennies. So it's like, dude, stop posting organically. Run a freaking damn ad. That's it. So I'm going to leave that. I'm not even going to touch that one. I'm going to leave it as is. Maximize reach of ads. It was there by default. I'm going to leave it there. I'm not going to mess with it. But I wanted to show you just the different ones. Here, look, daily budget. I'm literally going to go $1. $1. $1. And all you got to do is just mess with the calendar. So today is the second. What's the date? The date today. Today's the second. Today's the second. We're going to go the third. We're going to go Friday the third. We're going to go Friday the third. I'm going to start this. Yeah, we're going to go 6 a.m. 6 a.m. Okay, you want it early local time, whatever your local time is, run it at 6 a.m. And I'm going to run it only for, in fact, I'm going to run this for and I'm trying to get strategy behind it, right, you guys? Cuz lead ads, I don't need to really run lead ads from this particular page. This is going to be more of a brand awareness Facebook business page. So the videos, I'm going to just put brand awareness and just brand the hell out of the page and get thousands of people to watch the videos from the page, right? Get a ton of engagement, build a community, build that culture, just build, be more active on it, right? So the whole strategy behind brand awareness is to maybe run, here's what I recommend. And it's this simple. It really is this simple. Now, again, you could do two a month, two awareness a month, and two lead ads per month for sure. And crush it. And you're gonna let one video run. You're not running one every week. You're running one every 15 days. Okay. So for example, right now, May 3rd, I would have a brand awareness go for 15 days, and I can have a lead ad go for 15 days. Right. And that, this is just extra bonus stuff, you guys. I normally just recommend just lead ads. Do one lead ad every 15 days if you want to keep it that simple. This is just extra. This is just cream on the icing on the cake over here. I'm just showing you icing on the cake. That's why I'm just like, dude, I posted that video and I'm like, man, why don't I just run a damn ad on it and show you guys how I do it? Like, and that's what I'm doing here. But so long story short, this is gonna be awareness. And I can run awareness. I'll run this awareness for it. Let's just say we go 15 days. We go 15 days. So we go May 3rd. Let's just go May 3rd. May 3rd. Let's go May 3rd to May 17th. May 17th. In fact, you can even go, dude, I'm telling you, we're going at a dollar a day, you guys. So here's what I recommend you guys do. Here could be a simple to get it started video. Introduce yourself. This is a good brand awareness video for those of you that are watching this maybe for the first time and having this idea for the first time and saying, okay, that makes sense. Let me put out a video and let me run it under brand awareness and let me only target people who actually are interested in my stuff, right? Or who actually live in my area. Let me just target them. Like, right. So again, if you're a local business owner, this is how you're going to target just them. People who actually can walk to your business, people who actually can do business with you because you're licensed for that area, right? Or that state or whatever. Like, only show your stuff to people who matter. That's what I'm trying to show you here. Right. So again, I don't want to get, don't overthink this. Don't overthink this, which is what I'm kind of doing right now with how I want to structure my ads for the next month. But this one's just going to be fun. That's what this is. This is just icing on the cake, type of third bonus video. Run your two lead ads a month, and if you have extra budget, which is an extra, dude, stop buying bullshit crap to eat. Stop buying fast food. Stop buying coffee every damn day. That could be your simple little ad budget. I'm telling you, man, stop going to Starbucks. Stop buying fast food. That alone. Stop buying junk food. So even if you go to the grocery store and you happen to buy junk food, you buy some freaking Doritos, you bought some donuts, you bought some freaking cookies, you bought some freaking Lunchables for your kid when you should be cooking. Like, no, dude, stop buying this junk shit, and you can have this simple little stupid budget to actually guide your content, to actually put it in front of people where it matters, you guys. So don't overthink the time here, the schedule here. I'm going to go the 3rd to the 17th. Okay. And I'm going to end it at 6. That's it. We don't need anything there. This is where you would change your location. So if you live in whatever local area, you guys, dominate your local area. Look at this. I can go San Diego, California City. And I can even go even more niche. If I went Imperial Beach, look at that, dude. If I was a local business owner and my business is in Imperial Beach, if I was a local real estate agent and my farm where I'm trying to brand myself was Imperial Beach, that is literally a pin drop on the map. All I'm trying to say is put all your attention into just them. And I can even, yeah, I gotta go. Yeah, I can go down to 10 miles. Just 10 miles alone. God knows you're only doing business within a 10-mile radius alone. How many of your followers on social media live or will ever live in that area? If I was a real estate agent, I would most likely be crushing Imperial Beach if I lived in San Diego, if I lived in that area, whatever area. It could be Chula Vista, Eastlake, Coronado, Rancho Bernardo, Oceanside, Temecula. It could be anywhere. If I'm a real estate agent, I'm crushing my local area. At least I'm trying to. I'm going out. I'm networking. I'm at all these damn luncheons. I'm at all these damn conferences. I'm in meetings. I'm at happy hour trying to shake hands and kiss babies. I don't like that, but some do, right? But chances are you're doing it where you live. You're doing it where your kids go to school. You're doing it where you go to church. You're doing it in a local area, and that's plenty. If you're a real estate agent, how many of you would love to dominate? How many of you would love to be number one where you live? Okay, so if I live in Imperial Beach, that's plenty. I'm going to farm the hell out of that place and I'm going to crush it. So that's what I'm saying, you guys. This gives me the ability on $1 a day. Go back up to the budget on $1 a day. Come back to this video. It was at 19 earlier. You're going to see it at 1900 eventually off of $1 a day. Now, again, I'm only running it for this long and shit. In fact, you know what? Just run it for the rest of the month. One video that I recommend you guys do if you're doing this, if you're thinking about this for the first time, that's all I was trying to say earlier, is do an intro video. Pull out your phone and introduce yourself. And when you're doing video for Facebook ads, in this case, you can do it vertical, but vertical, you want to make sure it's under 1 minute. If I'm going to go on a rant, I'm going to make sure that I'm doing it here on my webcam. Here, I'm doing it on my computer. Or if I'm doing it on my cell phone, I'm going to make sure I hold the phone horizontal, landscape, widescreen, right? That's how you want to hold the phone. What I would do if I were you guys is I would introduce myself. Your background, your experience, your passion, how long you've been in your area, who you love serving in your area, why you're so fired up to help people in your area, how long you've been in business, your family, right? What you guys do on the weekend, what you love to do for fun. This is not a 30-second pitch. This is a freaking in-depth of introducing yourself. You're an entrepreneur, you're a father, a mother, you're a freaking proud parent, whatever. This is a chance to really open up and say, hey guys, my name is David. Just wanted to introduce myself. I'm a local realtor out here in Imperial Beach, California. Let me tell you why I'm so fired up to help homeowners sell their property, blah, blah, blah. It's not a pitch video. It's an intro. It's what I call, when I'm coaching clients, this is what I call step four, where we're introducing ourselves. And that's going to be the first video we run under brand awareness. I have all my clients do it. It's fun. It's simple. And that's the first video that you run to your local area under brand awareness to get thousands of people in your next, what I'm going to teach you next, in your custom audience. Okay, so let's get this. We got to end it here. We got to keep it going because I got a lot more to teach you. I'm going to teach you right here how to set this ad up. And this amount, by the way, this dollar amount, it could have been whatever. It could have been whatever. I could have went at $10 a day. So whatever your budget is, this is just an ad that I'm putting on the top of the cake. The icing is already there. The cherry is already on top. This is just an extra cherry, right? Where I'm going to just throw out another video. But again, rather than doing it like 99% of you guys organically, I'm actually going to target somewhere and I'm going to do it on a dollar a day. Stupid simple, right? So even if I rent it from the 3rd to the 31st, there's your freaking lunch money. Stop spending on freaking junk food and run some damn ads for your business, right? So this could have been anything under brand awareness, $1 to $10 a day. If you got a little bit more bread to spread, maybe go $15 a day. And again, you're doing this under brand awareness twice a month, once every 15 days. You can probably even do one once a month. Do one video per month. Make it like a commercial, not a pitch. Educate me on what the hell you do. You target homeowners who are looking to sell. Okay, educate me on what it takes to sell. There's so many things you can teach me, right? You're a professional, right? So pick your avatar, start teaching on that. And then again, here you guys, just start targeting your damn people. Start targeting them, okay? And keep it simple. So I'll just run it for the rest of the month. That's fine. 3rd to the 31st, because this is a really jam-packed video. And again, that video is so damn long, but at the same time, I'm not betting on people watching the whole damn thing. They don't need to. Once you watch 15 seconds of it, you're going to be in my custom audience. And then guess what? I'm going to turn around and show you my next ad. And when I show you my next ad, it's going to be for leads, right? And you're going to be more comfortable and warmed up with me because you saw this first one 2 weeks ago. And you knew that I was dropping bombs because I was teaching you some shit, right? So now next time you see me again, because I'm retargeting you, because you're in my audience, I'm going to show you how to do that next. That's what creates the brand. That's what creates the awareness for sure, but that's what creates the branding. That's the branding effect. When people can keep seeing you over and over and over and over, and you're not annoying because you're not pitching me. You're not just trying to say, hey, call me. No, dude. Hey, I'll list your property. No, dude, don't just try to pitch me all the time. Teach me what the hell you do. And you're going to have a percentage of those people, you guys, that reach out to you and want to do business. Okay, that's just how it works. That's how it's been working for me, at least. Thank God. So look, long video, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Now, my market is not Imperial Beach. I'm going after, in this case, I'm going to target a few different places. I'm going to target by country. United, I'm going to go United. And because I target by country, let me go back to the top level. I think what I'm going to have to do is change out. Well, actually, it's not showing me. Yeah, because I'm not in the category. If I was in the housing category, for example, and I'm going to target other places, then I would have had to choose the other countries or the other regions. In fact, let me just show you. So if I went housing, look what changes. If I went housing, now the countries. Now what I want to do is I want to click on that, go regions, and then check every box below. But I'm not going housing. Okay, I'm not going housing. So I don't need that. I don't want to confuse you with that. So next, I just needed to check that. Okay, next. Now we're back here. Maximize ads. There's the budget. There's the calendar. The locations. I'm gonna go United States. I'm gonna go Canada. I'm gonna go United States, Canada. I'll go Australia. United States and Canada. Because with this one, I'm targeting, I'm going to play around with the targeting. Let's play around with the targeting. Because I have in the title of the video, look, For realtors and local businesses, right? For realtors and local businesses. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to target pretty much all of them. And I'm going to do it just in these two countries, right? So again, you guys, where's your avatar? Is your avatar locally? Is your avatar globally? Is your avatar only in a few countries? Like, who is your avatar? That's the basics of marketing. If you don't know your avatar, you're not going to be able to pinpoint anyone. Your message isn't going to be speaking to anyone. And if it is, it's speaking to the wrong anyone's, right? You don't want that. You don't want to put all this damn effort in and put out this content and freaking try to talk to people about what you love to do when ain't nobody freaking caring, right? So here, these are where the majority of the people that I want to see this video. I'll have them right there. United States and Canada. Okay, cool. So now we're gonna scroll down. I'm gonna click on audience suggestions because this is what I want. I want to see the age. In my case, because I'm not going with housing or any of those categories, I can play with the age. So here I'm gonna play with the age. I'm gonna change that 18 again. Know your avatar. I'm gonna go 40. I'm gonna go 35. Actually, I'm gonna go 30. Let's go 30 to 65 plus. That's fine. All genders. Detail targeting. This is where I'm gonna play around with the detailed targeting. Now, if you're targeting locally, right? Because typically you would be a local business owner. You're a local real estate agent. I'm telling you to go under brand awareness a couple times a month, or at least once a month. Put out a power pack video and maybe just put that out once a month under brand awareness. So your monthly newsletter, your monthly market update, your local real estate agent, or even your local, well, not really local mortgage lender, because the mortgage you could do mortgages anywhere in that state. But even if you're a mortgage guy and you're trying to get the attention of your local area, because even you mortgage guys, you guys are at happy hour every damn day too. I was a loan officer. I was a mortgage guy for 6 years. I was at happy hour damn near three times a week. It's like shit, like out there networking, meetings, right? Before you know it, you're drunk by 7 p.m. You're like, holy crap. Like, what the hell? Did we even close on that deal? Right? So you're doing meetings all the time, even low mortgage guys, anyone, man, anyone. Target that person. Here, I'm going to play around with this. I'm going to put some detail target. Actually, yeah, let me put it, what I was going to say with that one is that even the mortgage guys, all you guys, if you guys are local, you don't have to put any detail targeting. That's all what I was going to say. You do not have to put any detail targeting interest-based keywords here if you're targeting a local area. Okay. But because I'm not, I do want to put in something. I want to target this to real estate agents, to real estate. Yeah, actually, I'm going to put a few real estate. Okay. So real estate, I want real estate job title, real estate agent. Let's even narrow it down. Real estate agent. Okay, perfect. This is what I wanted. So we got interest, and always you want to always look to the right. We got interest. We got job title, right? We got job title, agent, broker, real estate agent, salesperson, under employee. I'm gonna target those under job title. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm only going to put one word, right? One word. And I'm going to go with the real estate agent. This is the power word, right? In every industry, there's a power word. That's my power word, right? I'm going to go real estate salesperson. And then all I'm going to do is hit suggestions. And it's going to give me everything else under that power word. Facebook's going to give me everyone. So I don't got to guess and think of all these damn freaking words to put in. No, dude, put in one word and then hit suggestions. Okay. And these are all the similar ones to that one. Okay. So real estate broker job title. Yes. I want to target him. real estate broker employers. No, real estate associate. Yeah. Real estate consultant, real estate. So job titles. Realtor, that's fine. Job title. Let's go also with job title manager, real estate sales associate, job title, and that's fine for that. That's fine. Real estate sales associate, job title. They're all job titles, and that's perfect. Okay, good. And then, what I also want to put in here is I want to put. Let me see if that word's still available. Oh damn, what's that one keyword where it targets everyone who has a business page? Yeah, actually, Facebook for business. Yeah, right here. Perfect. Facebook page. Yeah, this is look, dude, I'm giving you some freaking ninja freaking thing strategies here, you guys. So if you're getting any value, freaking if you're even here at this timestamp, show me some love, dude. Comment below, give me a freaking like or something, dude, because I'm teaching you some ninja strategies here. Facebook page, I type that in, and now I can go with Facebook page admins, because anyone who has a Facebook business page, they are the admin of that page. And damn near 90% of us are local business owners. Nine or not necessarily local, but small. And I know my avatar, that's my avatar, right? You got to know your avatar. That's what allows you to get ninja with it, you guys. You got to know your avatar, right? Know your avatar. Know you're not talking to everyone. Know your message does not apply to everyone. You're fired up about a weight loss product. Narrow it in. Yes, does everyone need to lose weight? Of course. But you don't need everyone. Talk to one person. Talk to one person, you guys, and I'm telling you, it's going to be plenty. So in this case, I'm trying to talk to I could just talk to the realtor. That's who I normally talk to. But again, this is an awareness video where I'm going to open it up, I'm going to broaden it out a little bit. I'm going to target real estate, but I'm also going to target Facebook page admins, right? People who are an admin of at least one page on Facebook. That's powerful. That's gonna be more of my engagement. That's gonna be powerful. That's really, really powerful. Again, know your avatar. That's it. That's it. That's all the detail target I need. Advantage placements, leave it on that. Leave it on advantage plus placement. That's fine. And then now all I'm gonna do, based on what I did below, that's what I name at the top. $1 a day dash May dash May May 3rd to May 31st dash dash US and Canada dash let me turn my Okay, there we go. Okay, dash $1 a day da dash May 3 through 31 US and Canada real estate and page admin. That's it. That's it. That's it. I'm gonna just abbreviate at the top, you guys. I'm gonna title it at the top. Very, very important. All I'm gonna do is abbreviate what I did below. Okay, that's it. That's it. Scroll down, hit next. There's a third and final step of this step, you guys, and then we'll set up our custom audience and be done. Here, I'm gonna do the same thing. For realtors, same thing I named over here, but I'm gonna just simply take out this. Actually, I'm gonna copy all of it. I'm gonna copy all of it. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna simply just what I'm gonna put in parentheses in parentheses instead, video. That's it. That's it. And then scroll down. And because that post is already on the business page, I'm going to use existing post. I'm going to select post and I'm going to find that post. That post would be right. Where did it go? Where did it go? And if it doesn't show, actually, it's this one right here. Let's see. This length of your video is not supported for the in-stream placement, which is totally fine. Upload a video that it is 5 by 600 seconds long to deliver this placement. No big deal. You'll see that, but no big deal. Okay, it's actually this video right here. So, how to probably set up your business manager, April 15th. Let's just make sure that's the one. April 15th. Bam. All right, you guys. So we're good. So we're going to click on that, hit continue. And then we're going to scroll down. Now, this link, that's fine. We don't need it on that placement. We don't need them on all placements, right? We just really need it in the damn newsfeed. I could have just put it. You know what? You know what? Because it is long form, I could just put it in the newsfeed, which is typically what I do. I'll edit placements, and I'll put it in the newsfeed. But normally that's just on lead ads. So just on lead ads, I would have came over here on the ad set level, and down here on the placement, on the placements, I would have clicked on more, or I would have clicked on edit. Yeah, on the placements, click on edit, and you want to go manual. On a lead one, this is all part of testing, by the way. This is all part of testing. You could do one this way. Don't even touch it. Leave it advantage. That's test A. Test B is I run a manual one and I uncheck everything. I uncheck audience network and I come over here. I make sure I collapse this one right here to the left. Yeah. I want to make sure I collapse and I uncheck everything except for the Facebook feed. The Facebook feed, the Facebook marketplace, and then I would have unchecked stories because the video is too long and it's horizontal. I would have unchecked Facebook stories, unchecked reels. Right here, in stream, unchecked reels. On Instagram, it would have been Instagram. Yeah, none of those, none of those, n none of those, none of those. Okay, perfect. And then down here, search. Instagram search, that's fine. Messages, no. Apps and sites, no. So it would have ran just on, where's the Instagram stories? No, I don't want it on stories. Yeah, it could have been Instagram feed. Bam. So Facebook feed, Instagram feed, Facebook marketplace, and search. That's it. That would be my typical test and go to for lead ads, right? To really optimize and really, really, really save on spending more than needed, right? But in this case, I'm going awareness, you guys, so I'm gonna leave it advantage. Just for any analytical ones who were wondering, why David, why'd you go there? You know, I know there's gonna be questions. So that's that. I'm gonna leave it on advantage because this is awareness. Okay, so now here's what I'm gonna do. Use existing post. I already got that post. So we already know it's the length and the dimension is not fit for that other piece of the platform, which is totally fine. And then down here, I can the send message button. That I can leave that there for sure. Or what I can do is I could put learn more, because that's kind of actually, you know what? I'll go watch more and I'll grab my YouTube link. And because it's brand awareness, you guys, it's not even going to get clicked on. But guess what? When this ad is over, the reason why I post it on the business page first is because when the ad is over, the post still lives on forever. It's still public. It's still on my business page, right? That's why. And so I might as well put a button here just for the hell of it. So if people were to click on it, look at it now, it says watch more. If people were to click on it, it simply just takes them to my YouTube channel. So you want to optimize, you want to capitalize on every little piece of real estate you have on social media. Make sure your links, if you're sharing stuff online, make sure your links are optimized. You know, on Facebook alone, set up custom audiences around your links. So if you have a website, if you have a landing page, a sales funnel, whatever the hell, you're marketing yourself on the internet, on social media, at least make sure you own those links. Make sure that you have those links optimized. And make sure that you're creating custom audiences in the Facebook on the Facebook side, which I'm gonna show you next. That'll take 1 second. So stay to the end. Make sure you have all that set up, you guys, and you'll be in a good position. So start conversations. I don't need that. I don't need any of that. I don't need any of that. Website events. I don't need any of that tracking right there. None of that matters because it's a video ad. So all the tracking is done on Facebook. And again, because it's a brand awareness, not many people are going to even click on watch more. So it's not like you're going to get a lot of people clicking. So if you put a landing page there, it's not like a lot of people are going to be clicking. It's not meant for people to click. It's not a traffic ad. It's awareness. So it's literally designed to get you to get you to get people to see it. That's what it's designed for. So I'm gonna get thousands of views on this video, depending on what I'm spending per day, right? In this case, just a dollar. But at least it's targeting people that would benefit from my video. It's not just targeting my aunt who's following me on Facebook. No, dude, right? And she works at the mall. Like, no. So that button's there. I'm gonna hit publish. And that's it, you guys. Here on the bottom right, the blue publishing one of three. You're waiting for that to go green. It must go green. If it goes red, then you'll see whatever the error was. Click on it and it will walk you through it. But you're waiting for this to go green. Bam, we're in business. This video will go live. This ad will go live tomorrow. Here's the last thing I want to do, you guys. I want to come back over here. I want to the left-hand side. I want to look for my all tools. I want to look for the three lines. Click on all tools. Here's what you want to do right away. I just posted the video on my business page. I just set it up to go live as a Facebook brand awareness ad. Now, number three, I'm going to come over here and come to audiences. What I want to make sure that I'm doing right away is creating a custom audience for that. And I'm going to leave it in this group right there, in that group right there. So that's fine. And I'm going to go right here, video. I'm going to hit that top blue button to the left. I'm going to click on video. I'm going to choose the timestamp. I could create an audience of those that are watching it for 3 seconds, 10 seconds, 15, 25%, 50. The higher you go, the smaller the audience is going to be. That's why normally I don't go above 25%. Normally I'm right here about 15 seconds. If my video ad is scrolling through the newsfeed, scrolling through your newsfeed on Instagram, on Facebook, and you happen to watch a good 15 seconds of it, chances are when you see me again, you're going to recognize me. That's magic. That's the power of just 15 seconds alone. So typically most of the time, I'm going to just go 15 seconds. I'm going to just go 15 seconds. Because that's enough time and that's a good audience size we'll eventually build. I'm going to choose videos right here. I'm going to make sure I'm in the right Facebook page, right? You want to make sure you're in the right Facebook page. And then you're going to see that video, which is this one right here, April 15th, right? That's the one, the long ass one right there. That's it right there. I'm going to check the box. I'm going to hit confirm. I'm going to give it an audience name. And what I do is I simply name it what the video is. So for realtors and local businesses, that's going to be the name of my custom audience for realtors and local businesses, and then in parentheses, 15 seconds. In parentheses, 15 seconds. Create audience, and that's it, you guys. That is it. Post on the business page first. Set up the ad to go live the next day at 6 a.m. This is brand awareness, so you don't need to spend a lot. You could target your local area, get it seen by people who are actually interested. And remember, if you're targeting your local area, don't worry about putting any keywords. You don't need to. I had to put in keywords because I'm targeting multiple countries, right? But if you're targeting your local area of freaking Imperial Beach, you don't need to target any keywords. Just put in the location, the miles. You could play around with the miles, and that's it. And that right there, you guys, is person B. I highly recommend do that instead of thinking you need to post all over social media. No, you do not need to post all over social media, you guys. Target people who actually matter, and I'm guaranteeing you, you'll see your business take out to the next level. All right, guys, so subscribe if you're catching this on YouTube. Subscribe if you're on Facebook. Comment below. Reach out. Let me know what you guys are doing online. Let me know how I can bring value to what you guys are doing online, and I'll catch you on the next video. Over and out.